Hi guys, and welcome back to my World of Warcraft Let's Play series. Thank you once again for tuning in and checking out another one of my Starting Zone episodes. Today we have Cordelia. She is a gnome mage, and I just look at that little shit. She's just super cute. She's got her little Leia buns, although they're a little high, but it's the principal. She's got super cute pink hair, and she just winked at me. Did you, like, seriously? So I played a gnome maybe like once or twice just to, you know, check them out. And I've always loved those little gnomes that were running around with their bright pink hair. And I don't know, they were just adorable. And I just really, really wanted to do this one next. She was next in the series in line for the Alliance. So I was really excited to start this one. So we're sitting here. I have my tea ready to go. And I created a mage. I think we've done pretty much all of the classes so far. But I don't really want to do the Death Knight. I think that might deserve a video of its own. With whatever race I decide to do at the end, but we'll probably start to cycle through. Actually, now that I'm looking, I didn't do a mage yet. So Cordelia is our first mage. Anyways, enough rambling. We'll go ahead and start to enter the world of Warcraft.
Given the recent political upheaval in Ironforge, the gnomes have suddenly found themselves unwelcomed guests within the city. Leveraging their ingenious technologies and unquenchable spirit for adventure, the gnomes have begun to reevaluate their role within Cosmodan. Under the inventive leadership of High Tinker Gelbin Mechatork, the gnomes now plan a daring campaign against the barbarous Trolls to retake their former capital of Gnomeregon. With the odds stacked against them, the gnomes are counting on brave heroes such as you to stand and be counted. Your people's greatest hour draws near.
Okay, once again, we are here to save the world. So we are in Gnomeregon, it looks like, the dungeon that I absolutely despise. Before we get started, auto loot. See, guys, I'm getting better. I'm getting better at it. At remembering. So, oh my gosh, look at her. I just can't even stand it. I really think she's my new favorite. Oh, we're gonna have to see though, because we weren't sure. Well, I was kind of sure about the cows. And that was just an awful place. So I'm really hoping that this lives up to what I want. Look at her, she's got cute little pigtails. Okay, Nevin Twist Wrench has a quest. Greetings. Pinned down. My name is Nevin Twist Wrench, and I'm the commander of the Survivor Assistance Facilitation Expedition, or SAFE. I don't know how you managed to survive the radiation down here, Cordelia, but most of the others haven't fared so well. My team is rounding up the survivors, but the radiation-addled leper gnomes are too numerous for us to hold back much longer. They've lost their minds. If you're still strong enough to wield a weapon or cast a spell, would you help us clear out some of these leper gnomes? So, we have to kill 6 crazed leper gnomes, and they're over this way. Do gnomes not get racials? I guess not. That seems odd. Oops. Wrong one. Oh, escape artist. Escape the effects of any immobilization or movement speed reduction effect. Okay. Well, whatever, that's fine. We'll just stick with what we got. Which at this point is a Frostfire Bolt. Launches a bolt of frostfire at the enemy, causing 23 frostfire damage and slowing the target's movement by 40% for 8 seconds. Excellent. Alright, well, I can't kill him because he's grayed out, so we'll go after him. Easy peasy. Oh, he gave us some water. Frostfire bolt. Actually, I think that looks super cool. Yeah, sorry, got that already. Thanks for trying to help, whoever you were. Alright. Sweet. Look at him. He looks quite disturbed. Well, he's about to die, so now he's really disturbed. Oh, so they fly. And that kind of makes them hostile. Interesting. Alright, let's go after... Oh, no, you're... Oh, you're grabbing him. Okay, I see. Let's go. Oh, wow, sweet. That was a one-shot. Okay, let's go back. She runs pretty quick, which is nice. If you guys watched my Torin video, it was pretty painful. Pretty painful. Okay, Nevin, I killed the leper gnomes.
Salutations.
Well done, Cordelia. My men can take it from here. Let's focus on getting the other survivors out now.
Have a great day now.
Level 2. Report to Carvo Blastbolt. I'm going to start preparing my men to leave this place. We can't hold out here any longer. I want you to move to a forward position in the middle of the large room ahead. You should find Carvo Blastbolt there. He'll give you further instructions. Good luck, Cordelia, and I'll see you on the surface. So let's find Carvo Blastbolt.
Daylight's burning.
And Nomergon. Which, he should be up this way. So maybe he's gonna take us outside. All right, buddy.
Interesting.
Did Nevin send you ahead? That means he's getting ready to end the mission, but there are still survivors to be rescued. We have to help them. If we don't do something quick, neither Nevin nor the survivors will make it out of here alive. I'm going to give you my squad's emergency teleport beacon. We still have enough strength and ammunition to fight our way out of here, but those survivors are in no condition to make a run for it. Use the beacon on survivors to arrange for them to be teleported out of here to the safe area my men have set up. Once you've done that, report back to me and we'll make arrangements to get you out of here. So let's use the teleport beacon to save some peeps. Here's one. Come on, buddy. I got you. Now I suppose we'll go back down and grab some of these guys. Off you go. And you. They're so scared. I guess I'd be scared too if I had leper gnomes after me. There's four. So we have two more left. Here's one over here in the corner. Up, up, and away. I'll get you. He's so nervous. All right. Carvo, I did it. I know Nevin will be pleased with all the survivors you managed to help. I still can't believe you managed to stay so strong down here in the radiation. You've seen the shape the other survivors are in. Let's get you to the loading room for decontamination.
Seeing you.
All right. Excellent job gathering the other survivors. They and you are the reason safe teams keep coming down here. Nevin won't rest until we've found and rescued every possible survivor. I'm sending my men to the loading room to prepare for decontamination. Please follow them and meet up with Gaffer Coilspring when you arrive. She'll set you up for decontamination and have you on your way to the surface. So we're following safe operatives to Gaffer Coilspring.
Daylight's burning.
In the loading room. So what am I doing? Am I going this way? Looks like I'm going this way. withdraw to the loading room. Is this right? This doesn't look right. Did I make it? Yes, I did it. Alright, cool. Alright.
Can I help you?
It's good to meet you, Mage. We rarely come across survivors as strong and capable as you are. I can help get you decontaminated and on your way out of here.
Alright then.
You've been down here in Nomuragon for a long time, Cordelia, and it's amazing that you've survived and kept your wits so long. We need to get you out. Before we can send you to the surface to join the rest of the gnomes, you have to go through the decontamination process. Just head into the next room and board the Sanitron 500. It will do the rest. It shouldn't even hurt much. Well, that doesn't sound safe. Gaffer, you're supposed to be part of the safe crew. Well, that just doesn't sound like I want to do that. When you're all done, check in with Technician Braggle and he'll make sure you get some suitable gear. So, I guess we're going in this way. Oh, goodness. Decontamination process started. Oh no! Oh geez! Oh look at him, just hanging there. Look at me. Aww. Ah! They shocked me. What in the world? Okay. That hurt a lot. Okay, there. Now you're fit to head off to the surface and start your new life. The High Tinker will be delighted to hear of your arrival. So to the surface. Nevin has just sent word that he and his men are making their way to the surface. He'll be waiting for you in the building that Safe has established as its headquarters. See Torben Zapblast over there? Talk to him when you're ready to head to the surface and he'll arrange to have you transported up there. It's been a pleasure meeting you, Cordelia, and I'm honored to have played a small role in helping you escape from Nomuragon to start your life on the surface. So let's go speak to Torben Zapblast so we can get up onto the surface.
Hi, how are
let's
you?
Let's go. Send me to the surface. Torben. Okay. Nevin.
Can I help you?
It's good to see you again, Cordelia. Without your help, we wouldn't have been able to get so many survivors out of Nomuragon this time. Everyone is going to be thrilled to meet you and hear your story.
You have a great day now.
Well, I didn't realize I was so famous.
Greetings.
All right. The future of Nomuragon. It's a victory for us every time we're able to help another survivor escape from the contaminated halls of Nomuragon. Mages like you will play an important part in the future of Nomuragon. To that end, our leader, High Tinker Mechatork, has assembled a team of trainers to help you learn your arts. Bipsy Frostflinger will help oversee your training and adjustment to life on the surface. She's waiting for you outside the tall building to the northeast. Let's go find Bipsy.
You.
That's the greatest name. Alright, I wonder... Wow, she's really tall. I really look up to her. Okay. There's Bipsy. She is the mage trainer.
Good day.
Cordelia, isn't it? It's a pleasure to finally meet you. While you were getting cleaned up, Nevin's team told me about your escape from Nomuragon. Meet the High Tinker. I don't know if you'll remember Mechatork or not. Nevin tells me that memory loss is pretty common for a Nomuragon survivor. Mechatork, or more properly, the High Tinker Mechatork, is the leader of all the gnomes. He has made a habit of meeting with every rescued survivor personally. You should introduce yourself to him. He'll be with his war council beneath the tent in the center of town.
You have a great day now.
Oh, and here's another one. The Arts of a Mage. As you go on wild adventures and grow your power, you'll start to develop new connections to the arcane, granting you new spells. You'll see. Go do it. Show me what you learn. I'll be here. So we have to reach level 3, which we have not done yet, to learn Frost Nova. And once we've learned that, we'll cast it twice at the training dummy in New Tinkertown, and we'll get an Electro Staff, which is really awesome. I can't wait to get that. Okay. So we're going to the center of town to meet... what's his name? Mechatork. There he is. I feel like this is very informal for him. Like, he should be in some grand palace tent, not in some dinky little makeshift thing. I don't know. He deserves more, right? King of Gnomes, it's good to meet you, Cordelia. You've probably heard others speaking of Operation Nomergon. Let me tell you a bit about what happened and why we left the dwarven city of Ironforge. The fight continues. The dwarves of Ironforge kindly took us in when the Trog invasion and radiation forced us to leave Nomergon for the first time, which we actually have experienced since we did the dwarf starting zone already. But even the kindness of friends can't quell the longing for home. I sent out a call for brave gnomes and other members of the Alliance to help us regain control of Nomergon and defeat the usurper Thermaplug once and for all. We weren't able to achieve everything Operation Nomergon set out to do, but Thermaplug is on the run and we're closer to home than ever. So watch the hollow table in front of High Tinker Mechatork to learn about Operation Nomergon. So, where is that?
We assembled a mighty force and defeated Thermaplug's servants, fighting our way into the city.
We're listening to a story.
But the usurper Thermaplug had one last trick up his sleeve. Too quiet. Where are Thermaplug's defense forces?
No, 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 no! I won't allow you into my kingdom, usurper! I won't allow it! Activate the ultimate atomic protection system! Disintegrate them all!
It's a trap! That's a fully functional irradiator!
Irradiator 3000 activated.
Attention.
Emergency. You now have 10 minutes to reach minimum safe distance.
10 minutes? Plenty of time to disarm the device. Hinkles, hand me that whirring bronze gizmo and some fresh spring water. Cogspin, toss me that dirty trog cloth and a handful of copper bolts.
10 minutes!
Attention, emergency.
We've got to get out of here. Lap torch, beam us back quickly. Distance.
Well, that was very fun.
Thermaplug continues to hide behind the radiation, sending his crony Crush Cog to harass us here on the surface.
Gotcha. All right.
Welcome, friend.
Even now, only the safe teams dare to venture far into the city to search for survivors. Meanwhile, Thermaplug has sent one of his followers, Crush Cog, to distract us and buy time for him to dig in. So, a triumph of gnomish ingenuity. We will need all the weapons, inventions, and soldiers we can get in order to defeat Razlo, Crush Cog, and his followers. Over to the northeast, you'll find engineer Grind Spark, one of a new generation of brilliant gnomish minds. Why he hasn't had an explosion in over 3 prototypes. But enough bragging. Engineer Grindspark is working on a bot that he says will help clean up the toxic airfield. You should introduce yourself to him and see if he needs any help testing it. Well, let's go do it. Let's go find Engineer Grindspark, wherever he may be. Up this way? He's probably in this. See, up here? Now that is a place that Mechatork should be living in. That just seems weird. Does that seem weird? Maybe it's just me.
Salutations!
So, Mechatork himself has heard of my little project. Splendid. I've almost finished my latest prototype, but maybe you can help me chase down those last few parts. So we're going to be scrounging. There's just too much to do around here and too few gnomes on their feet to help. The High Tinker has asked me to start converting some of our old bots and parts from Operation Gnomergon. I hope to have a new line of multibots ready for a field test soon. I don't suppose you'd have some time to help, do you? There are all kinds of parts scattered around. Pick up anything you find and bring it back to me. You never know what could turn out to be useful. So let's find some spare parts for good old Grind Spark here. So we need 7 of them. Awesome. So we got a coil over here. Let's just loot everything. We got some gears. Come on. I must tell you that I'm very jealous of Cordelia right now, because she is walking around in the snow. And it is now December, whatever it is. I just checked my phone. The 15th. It is December 15th. And it's like 60 degrees. It's insane. I don't like winter. I'm not a huge fan of winter. But I believe it should be cold and very frigid temperatures around Christmas time. Snow, maybe, just a little bit. Nothing crazy. But can you believe it? It's like 60 degrees. Grind Spark, I have your spare parts. These are fantastic. Let's see what we can put together. Would you be interested in testing out the prototype once I'm done? If the multibot works, it will help us do all kinds of jobs that are unpleasant or dangerous for us gnomes. After Thermoplug detonated his irradiator at the end of Operation Gnomergon, toxic clouds and ooze began bubbling up at the old airfield south of town. If we don't get it under control, the contamination could spread to the rest of our lands. Take the multibot with you and bring it close to the geysers in the green pools at the toxic airfield. Your bot should spring into action. So we're using the GS9X multibot to clean up 5 toxic geysers at the toxic airfield. And he's supposed to just know how to do that. And is there another quest? Maybe I see an exclamation point. Maybe he's in here. No. Interesting. Okay. I saw an exclamation point. Oh, he's down here. Got it. All right. Talk. Spry Sprocket.
Hey.
Most of us have seen the sickly and deranged gnomes suffering from exposure to the poisons and radiation of Gnomergon. Eventually, they will devolve further until they become mindless, but mostly harmless puddles of toxic sludge. My research suggests that we may even be able to restore them from this state. Go to the toxic airfield to the south, subdue the toxic sludge I told you about, and bring back the possessions of the gnomes they once were. So, retrieve 6 recovered possessions from toxic sludges at the toxic airfield. So, we are going to do some quests at the airfield. And we still have to reach level 3. This is actually leveling pretty slow. But we'll, I'm sure once we get going on all of these, we'll level pretty quick. But we got our little bot here with us. And we have another quest this way. Let's check it out. Is it in here? Why am I losing quests? Why do I not know where these things are? Corporal Fizz Whistle.
Interesting.
Tox Spry Sprocket has some crazy theory about these toxic sludges being the last remnants of gnomes. so my men have orders not to engage them for now. However, the toxic airfield just south of us is teeming with living contamination. They are elementals composed of contaminated water and other toxic materials. Left unchecked, they'll overrun the town. Will you help us dispose of them? Destroy 6 living contaminations at the toxic airfield. So we have a lot to do here. So I'm excited now. So, we got one. Do we still have our... Yeah, there he is. All right. Take that. And that. All right, 2 of 6. So what are we supposed to do with these little bolt bots? They're supposed to just kind of know what to do. I'm sorry. Get close enough to a geyser. Okay, well that's not a geyser. So let's go over this way. I thought this guy had a hat on. This little sludge guy. I guess he kind of did. All right, let's check out the geysers. Go. Do what you're supposed to do. Why aren't you doing what you're supposed to be doing? Young snow leopard, you need to get out of here. Okay, I'm in the geyser. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I literally have to be, like, on top of it for you to do anything. Got it. Got it. And there's our level. There's our Frost Nova that we'll practice once we get back. And our Frost Nova... It blasts enemies within 12 yards of the caster for 5 frost damage and freezes them in place for up to 8 seconds, but then damage caused may interrupt the effect, which it most likely will. But we'll probably just set that number 1 anyway. It doesn't really help us out too much, so we'll just leave that alone. Oh, hello, roach. Oops. Didn't mean to kill the roach. I really didn't. Okay, next. Toxic sludge. So we have one more geyser to take care of. One more living contamination, which will get him right here. And I think we need just 2 more of these little possessions. Covered possession. Oh, he's done. Okay, the geysers are over this way. Go ahead. All right, that's it. We've done it. So now we're going to head back, we're going to turn in a bunch of those quests, and we're going to go practice Frost Nova with the training dummies, and at that point maybe we'll be close to level 4. Corporal Fizz Whistle.
Can I help you?
What a relief. Thank you for your help. I hope that gadget Engineer Grindspark was working on helps get the airfield cleaned up permanently. So, oh. Are we gonna get both of these? Yeah, we get both.
Nice seeing you.
Awesome. Let's put on this cape. Just for fun. And we got an extra bag slot. That is always useful. Next. Going up this way. Going back up the hill. Where are the training dummies? Here they are. Might as well go ahead. Take care of that. And turn in all 3 of those quests. Bipsy. You picked that one up quickly. I can't wait to show you some of my other favorite tricks.
Off and away.
Give me that staff. Awesome. And Engineer Grindspark? Wow, I never expected it to work on the first trial. We've succeeded. I wonder what other uses we can find for this handy little guy.
Right.
Wow, just... That's great. Spry Sprocket. I was able to recover the belongings. I can't wait to give this new technology a try. We've lost more gnomes to radiation than we can count. It's time to turn that around.
Daylight's burning.
Excellent. Now, we are off to find out who else has a quest for us. And that would be Captain Tread Spark Nozzle.
Hey.
That is Mechatork's advisor. The cataclysm tore open deep caves beneath Frostmane Hold, and Trogs flooded out of their warrens. They succeeded in displacing the trolls who used to live there, and they stand to drive us out if we do not act. High Tinker Mechatork hired the renowned demolitionist Jessup McCree to close the caves and stem the Trog advance. We've received no word about whether he was able to stop the Trogs. Would you look for him at his camp near Frostmane Hold to the south beyond Toxic Airfield?
You have a great day.
Let's
now.
Go find him. I'm sure he's okay. But we still have not hit level 4. So we may need to cut this episode in half. We'll have to see. But we'll just keep going, and we're going to find Jessup at his camp. All right. We have found Jessup.
How are ya?
It won't be tough to collapse the tunnel, but I'm gonna need my team and my equipment afore I can get to the task. Gotcha. So he's got two quests for us. Get me explosives back. It's going to take a lot of powder to collapse those caves. I don't know whether the damnable Trogs understood that when they stole me supplies and kidnapped me demolitionists, but the outcome's the same. Ain't gonna be able to blow nothing up until I've got that powder back. Go south to Frostmane Hold and kill any of those Trogs you find. Any one of them could be carrying my kegs of powder. So let's recover 7 stolen powder kegs from the Rockjaw Bone Pickers or Rockjaw Marauders.
Off with you.
And missing an action. For a job like this, I normally bring me whole crew of demolitionists. With some help in setting up the powder, the charges, and the rest of the gear, the job gets done a lot faster. Those blasted Trogs have me men caged all around Frostmane Hold. Now I'm here all alone without the personnel I need to finish the job. You look like a capable mage, though. Would you find the demolitionists the Trogs captured and break them out of their cages? He's tripping me up with his dialogue. So free 6 captured demolitionists from their cages around Frostmane Hold.
Watch your back.
We are actually going to accept this quest. Let's just go ahead and do it. Let's kill some of these marauders and get the stolen powder kegs. And that was pretty easy. Done. Oh, okay. I thought I was stabbing him. That wouldn't be good. All right, we can do it. Oops. All right, I got you at least. Awesome. Excellent. So we have 2 more kegs to grab, and I don't know how many cages we have. Oh, we're halfway there. Hello. All right, almost there. Can we get him? Yeah, we reached him. All right, we are done with the kegs. Now we just need to get two more of the captured demolitionists. All right, Jessup, I've completed
What's
your tasks.
On your mind?
Get me explosives back. I did recover them. Well, now that's more like it. We may get around to blowing up something after all.
See you soon.
You have me own thanks and the thanks of the men you rescued. I've already had the boys start setting up the gear down inside the cave. It should be ready to go soon. My team has finished setting up the powder kegs. Well, that was awfully fast, Jessup. And the detonator at the bottom of the cave in the western part of Frostmane Hold. All you need to do is venture down there and activate the detonator to explode the powder and collapse those tunnels. That'll stop the flow of trogs from the deep parts of the earth. Mechatork will have an easier time of dealing with the remaining trogs if you can take out their leader, who calls himself Boss Brugger. Good luck, Cordelia. At the bottom of the cave in Frostmane Hold, kill Boss Brugger and activate the detonator to detonate the
Watch
trogs tunnels.
Great Wait, to meet you.
Did I turn in all those quests? I guess I did. All right. This is the cave that we will venture forth through, and we will blow up. We gotta get the boss. Boss man. And we get to kill some on the way. So that should help. Might go in the right way. I always lose where I'm going. I hate caves. Dead. Might as well kill you too, fungus flinger. We seem like we're getting pretty deep into the cave, so... Oh, there he is. Oh boy. He looks like a biggin. Okay, there's the detonator. So get these guys out of the way. And we'll kill this guy. Come on, boss. Alright, I probably need to get out of here quick. Let's hope I don't get lost. And you. Alright, I made it. I made it! That's exciting. Okay, where did you go, mister? Alright, here you go. I did it. I could feel the explosion way up here. Well, that's funny, because I was right inside and I didn't feel anything. My boys did a fine job rigging up that blast, but it wouldn't have happened without your help. It's only fair that I split my contract payment with you for helping me finish the job. And we're going to get some bracers. Let's put them on. Well, it's time to start packing up and moving on to the next job. There's always something else to blow up out there. Somewhere there's a mountain needs moving or a gorge that needs carving, and I'll be there to do it. I don't suppose you'd do me one more favor. Would you take this report back to High Tinker Mechatork in New Tinkertown? He needs to know that the Trogs won't be bothering his people again anytime soon.
Safe travels.
Let's go do that for old Jessup. Let's head back and talk to the High Gnome. Oh, that's right. He's in that little dinky tent. There he is, up there. All right, Mechatork. I have a report.
Why, hello there. How can I help you?
The High Tinker reads Jessup's report. Splendid news. With the Trogs taken care of, we should be able to turn our attention to Crush Cog's troublemaking. crush Cog's minions. Our old enemy Thermoplug is doing his best to keep us from rebuilding and finishing our reclamation of Nomargon. He sent one of his most loyal henchmen, Razlo, crush Cog, and a force of irradiated gnomes to harry us. They've taken over an old arsenal up the road to the north, and crush Cog's technicians are repairing those weapons. We have to stop them before they're able to get those mechano tanks back online. Go to Crush Cog's arsenal and eliminate as many of the technicians as you can. So we are killing 8 of them. And it looks like we're hit. We have another quest over here. My goodness.
Pleased to meet you.
Fast Blast. We've lost more than a couple scouts trying to find out what exactly Razlo Crush Cog plans to do with all those mechano tanks his irradiated technicians are repairing. We can't afford to take it slowly anymore. We must act before Crush Cog turns his followers and his weapons on us. This techno grenade packs enough explosive power to destroy the mechano tanks and deny Crush Cog their use. Take it north with you along the road to Crush Cog's arsenal and take out those tanks. So, we got some things to do. We're so close to level 5. So close. Where are we going? Okay, here we are. And we are killing some irradiated technicians and killing some tanks. All right. Well, this is just jolly. I'm actually really enjoying this starting zone. How much do you want to bet that, good old Mecha Tube or whatever his name is gonna make us come back here and actually kill the boss man? That's what I predict. Woohoo! We hit level 5. I'm gonna get you a while. Oh, come on, really? I'm busy. I'm trying to kill this other tank. Oh, I got Fire Blast. All right, we have one more of the minions. And last tank. And let's go. What does the Fire Blast do? Well, that's fun. That's took half his life away. All right. We have completed the tasks. So we're gonna go and head back to Mechatron, whatever, and we're gonna tell him that we did what he asked. Hi, Tinker. Oh, Mechatork. What I was like, I was calling him everything else.
Necessity,
that should set back Crush Cog's plans a bit, but we can't rest until he is defeated and Chillbreeze Valley is secure. See what I tell you. Hinkles? Mechatork will be pleased to hear that you've ruined Crush Cog's plans to use our old weapons for his followers. Without the mechano tanks under his command, he'll be weak and vulnerable. So we got...
Right.
A belt. Okay. Well, guys, I know that was incredibly long, way longer than a lot of the starting zones, but that was a lot to do, I feel. I really, really like her. I think she's super cool. Cordelia is pretty awesome. I really hope that you guys liked her as well, and I hope you liked this starting zone. Comment down below. Let me know if you have any suggestions, any comments, anything. That you would like me to do for either these Let's Plays or anything on the channel, I always look forward to that, of course. Give me a thumbs up and a subscribe if you want to be notified every time I post a new video. And as always, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week. Take care. See you next time.